Today, children, I will complete the last part of Act 1, Scene 2. In the previous part, we came to know that Nerissa names the suitors one by one, and by the way Portia was describing them, we come to know that she was not interested in any of them and she didn't want to marry any of those suitors. Now I will continue further. Nerissa, you need not fear, lady, the having any of these lords. They have acquainted me with their determinations. So Nerissa here tells Portia that she should not fear having to marry any of these lords, that is any of these suitors, because they have acquainted me. Acquainted means informed me with their determinations. Determinations means decision. Because the suitors had informed Nerissa about their decision, which is indeed to return to their home and to trouble you with no more suit. And what was their determination, their decision, the suitors' decision? That they were going to return to their home without choosing the casket and not to trouble Portia with any more suit. And why were they not willing to choose the casket? Because they were not ready to agree particularly to the second condition regarding the choosing of caskets. And what was the second condition? That if they choose the wrong casket, then they will never ask any other lady in their life to marry them. So they didn't want to be they didn't want to remain a bachelor throughout their life if they chose the wrong casket. So they all had decided to return home without choosing the casket, unless you may be won by some other sort than your father's imposition, depending on the caskets. So they were not ready to choose the casket. They were ready to win Portia by some other sort. Sort means some other method, and not by her father's imposition. Imposition means the conditions laid down by her father, depending on the caskets. Portia, if I live to be as old as Sibylla, I will die as chaste as Diana, unless I be obtained by the manner of my father's will. So here Portia says that if she lives to be as old as Sibylla. Now here Sibylla was a prophetess who was granted a very long life by Apollo, a god. And so Portia says that if she also lives a long life like Sibylla, then she will die as chaste as Diana. Chaste means virgin, and Diana is the goddess of virginity. So she will die, she will live a long life, but she will die a virgin, that is without marrying anyone, unless I be obtained by the manner of my father's will. Unless she is obtained. Obtained means won. She is won by the manner, by the method, or according to her father's will. That is, if anyone chooses the right casket, then only she could marry. Otherwise, she will remain a virgin throughout her life. I am glad this parcel of wooers are so reasonable, for there is not one among them but I dote on his very absence. And here Portia says that she was very happy, very glad that the parcel of wooers means the group of suitors were so reasonable. Reasonable means that they had decided to leave without choosing the casket, because there is not one among them but I dote on his very absence. Because there is not even one suitor among them whom she would regret if he goes away. That means she was happy that all of them were going away. She was not feeling sorry for any of their absence. And I pray God grant them a fair departure. And she prayed that God should give them a fair departure, that is a happy journey. Nerissa, do you not remember, lady, in your father's time, a Venetian, a scholar and a soldier, that came hither in company of the Marquess of Montferrat. So here Nerissa is trying to remind Portia about Bassanio, and she asks Portia that whether she remembered that in her father's time, that is when her father was alive, a Venetian, that is a citizen of Venice, a scholar and a soldier that came hither, that who used to come here in the company of Marquess of Montferrat. So there was a Venetian who used to come to Belmont with the Marquess of Montferrat. Marquess of Montferrat, it is a title used for an Italian nobleman. So Bassanio used to visit Belmont and meet Portia's father with this Italian nobleman. And here Nerissa mentions that Bassanio was a scholar and a soldier. But Bassanio was neither a scholar nor a soldier. Here Nerissa says this because Portia would be happy to hear such a thing. Portia: yes, yes, it was Bassanio, as I think, so was he called. So Portia also remembers, and she says that it was Bassanio. As I think, so was he called, so was his name. Nerissa: true, madam, he of all the men that ever my foolish eyes looked upon was the best deserving of fair lady. And here Nerissa praises Bassanio, saying that of all the men who that ever my foolish eyes looked upon means have seen, that all the men that she had ever seen, out of all those men, Bassanio was the most deserving to win a fair lady. Best deserving a fair lady means that Bassanio was the most deserving to win a beautiful lady. Portia: I remember him well, and I remember him worthy of thy praise. So Portia also says that she remembers Bassanio very well, and she also remembers that he is worthy of Nerissa's praise. That is, Bassanio was fit to be praised. He was indeed a very good man. Enter a servant. How now, what news? Now at that moment when they were talking, a servant enters, and how now, hello. And Portia asks the servant what news he has brought. Servant: the four strangers seek for you, madam, to take their leave. Now here, the four strangers means the visitors, that is the suitors. So the servant says that four suitors had wanted to meet Portia to take their leave. That is, they were leaving Belmont. So before leaving, they wanted to meet Portia. And there is a forerunner come from a fifth, the Prince of Morocco. And as these four suitors were leaving, there is a forerunner. Forerunner means a messenger. A messenger had come from a fifth suitor, who was the Prince of Morocco, who brings word the prince, his master, will be here tonight. And what had that messenger brought? What news had he brought? That the prince, his master, that is the Prince of Morocco, would be reaching Belmont that night. Portia: if I could bid the fifth welcome with so good heart as I can bid the other for farewell, I should be glad of his approach. Now here Portia is a little bit annoyed, and she says that if she could welcome the fifth suitor with so good heart means so happily as he was bidding the other four farewell, then she should be glad of his approach. Approach means arrival, of his coming. So just as she was happy in bidding farewell to the four suitors who were going, in the same way, if she was as happy as that in welcoming the fifth suitor, then she would be glad of his approach. If he have the condition of a saint and the complexion of a devil, I had rather he should shrive me than wife me. And here she expresses again her dislike. And she says that if he has the condition means the nature. If he has the nature of a saint, that is, if he is as good as a saint, but he has the complexion of a devil. Complexion means if he has the appearance of a devil, then I had rather he should shrive me. Then she would prefer that he hears her sins. Shrive me means hears her sins and forgive her. Than wife me. Rather than wife me means rather than marry her. So if this fifth suitor who was coming, if he had the nature of a saint and had the complexion, had the appearance of a devil, then she would prefer that he just hears her sins and forgives her instead of marrying her. Come Nerissa, Sirrah, go before. And then Portia tells Nerissa to come with her. And Sirrah here is an expression used for servant. And she tells the servant to go before, that is to go ahead of them. Whilst we shut the gate upon one wooer, another knocks at the door. And Portia in the end she says that while they were shutting the gate upon one wooer, that is as one suitor left, another knocks at the door. Another had already come. So, children, this is the end of Act 1, Scene 2. I will be sending two salt extracts of this scene. You may write them in your, write down those extracts with answers, questions and answers in your register. After that, you listen carefully to all the explanations and solve the other extracts in your workbook on your own.